Almighty.
Glad to be here.
Today is a very sorrow day. Today is a day that we have come to actually mourn the loss, mourn another golden link in a chain of people who have stood up to oppose a vile nationalism, a selfish movement, a movement that has clothed itself in holiness, that has hijacked a religion, that has hijacked the Jewish identity, our identity, in order to perpetrate a most horrific crime, stealing the identity of the Palestinian people, their homeland, their self-respect, and everything else that belongs to them. And in order to perpetrate this selfish, flawed nationalism, which is called Zionism, and eventually which became the State of Israel, this movement decided, although they detested God and religion, Theodor Herzl, Ben-Gurion, Chaim Weizmann, all these people openly detested God and furthered themselves from religion. Yet these hypocrites put on a mantle of religion, used the Star of David and the name of Israel. How repugnant! In order to be able to get their legitimacy, to wave the Bible as a deed to take the land from the Palestinians, and in order to accuse everybody who stands up for godliness, for the rights of the Palestinians, as they are anti-Semitic. And that is a crime, one of the worst crimes, because they have intimidated the world. They have made that there is a deafening silence among the leaders of the world. People who, after 2 days of watching what happens in Haiti, or Katrina, or tsunami, make investigations. How come assistance takes so long? And what was the drawback? What happened? What went wrong if there's 2 or 3 days extra in providing assistance? And that's proper. That's the way it should be. Yet, when it comes to Gaza, we, a contingent of rabbis from Jerusalem, from UK, from Canada, and from the US, we went there just a few months ago with Freedom Gaza March and Viva Palestina. And we went and we visited Gaza Strip. We visited a place called Zaytun, where there's a family called Samuni family that has over 29 members from one single family were murdered. And the world knows about it because they took these members of the family who were injured to Europe for treating the medical treatments. And we went to visit them on the day a year after the murder. And they're still living, not in tents, mind you. They're living in streams covered with plastic, freezing at night. It's unbearable heat during the day. No proper water. We have pictures of this. Nobody could refute it. And the world is silent. How could they be silent? And the answer is very simple. Because the world has accepted that this is a religious conflict. They have accepted the ploy, the Zionist propaganda spiel of over 60 years, that the Arabs hate the Jews, and that these people of Gaza are villains, and the State of Israel is a victim. There could be nothing further from the truth. History attests to the fact that we, as a religious Jewish community, was living and enjoying the close friendship, camaraderie with the Palestinian people, as we have in every Arab and Muslim land for hundreds of years, and we are required by the Torah to demonstrate our appreciation, our thankfulness for the safe haven and exemplary hospitality, even by World War II. Turkey, we're talking about Turkey now, provided for us a home. And what are they being paid back with? Accusations that they are the worst anti-Semites. The skies are screaming. Our hearts are rent. Jews from around the world, our hearts are bleeding. We feel the suffering of the people of Gaza. And now, the new link in this long chain, the people of Turkey. The world has to know. Human rights activists, which means the majority of the world, people with heart, they have to do what we did at the time in the apartheid in South Africa, where the governments went on their merry ways till the grassroots said to the governments, you cannot go on like this. This is racism. This is blatantly wrong. We have to stand up, first of all, as a people who believe in God. We must fervently pray to the Almighty to remove this aberration, to remove this impediment to peace, which is called the State of Israel, not a religion. We've been coexisting Jews and Muslims and Christians for hundreds of years. That is not the problem, it's the new neighbor to the block. The new infusion to the equation, which is Zionism. Just remove this, and we can once again live as we have for hundreds and hundreds of years. History attests, and there are people in their 70s and 80s who will attest to our coexistence. Where is humanity? Where is the logic? Where is the common sense? If you have a problem, study it. Why, till 100 years ago, Jewish community thrived in Egypt, in Turkey, in Yemen, in Iran,
in Palestine,
and in Palestine? What has changed? One thing has changed. A new thing.
I'm a ham.
A flawed, selfish, vile rebellion against God called a movement of nationalism called Zionism. The transformation of the Jewish religion into a material nationalism, taking God out of the equation. It happens to be that according to the Jewish law, the Jewish people are forbidden to have their own state since the destruction of the temple, even in an uninhabited land. And that is a fact for why 2,000 years Jews have never made a state. Now the fact that they decided to create this national home in a land that was inhabited by the Palestinian people, that just makes thousandfold this crime, and it breaches every other law of the Torah, that thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal. One must emulate God. That is why you will find around the world, wherever there is a very religious Jewish community, the more religious, the more anti-Zionist. You don't see that in the mainstream media, because the Zionists intimidate the press and accuse them of being anti-Semitic if they reveal the truth or they show too much sympathy for the Palestinian people. That is the single ploy of Zionism. But let me tell you, go do your homework. Go around the world, you will find the religious communities true to the Torah stand in steadfast opposition, and we cry and we pray for the people of Palestine, of Gaza, and now for the people of Turkey and of Lebanon. I will end with this. We want you to know, and we plead with you. Do not call it a Jewish state. Do not call it the Jews. It is a Zionist state. It is the State of Israel. And let us all pray for the speedy and peaceful dismantlement of the state. And let us pray for ultimately the day that the Jews really hope for, where God will make a metaphysical change with all the world. When the whole world will recognize God, we will serve Him in harmony. Then we will go up, embrace all people together, not a state. Let me tell you something again. I must end. I just want to say that you all have to know.
Let them reload their tapes.
That you should not be intimidated. You must, if you're accused of being anti-Semitic, you're not. You must stand up. God requires to stand up for compassion and righteousness. Stand up for the people of Gaza. Let the world hear. We cannot continue this the silence.
Just wait. Rabbi Weiss will be available for interviews as well, but I also want everyone to see this is not about anti-Semitism, this is not about religious hate. This movement and the Palestinians would be nowhere without progressive Jews and even religious Jews who know that this is a crime. And Muslims and Jews live in peace in all parts
of the world. And Christians.
And Christians as well. And this is more proof of it right here. The next speaker